Rides is really, it's a culmination of obviously a bunch of development and testing, like all rides are, but in this particular experience, you have a lot of overlapping systems, you have humans obviously being carried through the space, and we could see here that you have multiple ride vehicles all in place. Dawson, I'd love to talk a little bit about the use of FRV in testing rides. So not actually in practice even yet, just the testing phase.
Sure, and actually I think this is a perfect transition because Rise of the Resistance was actually one of the first attractions that we've ever done with this pipeline we're about to talk about that is incorporating literal physical free-roaming vehicles as well as virtual reality to get our designers into the process faster.
And previously, I know that VR had been used in like static configurations, just to pre-vis rides and that sort of thing, right? But not on a moving platform.
So when I actually started, we used to build, and we still do, these physical models. You would sit on a stool, and you would sort of like scoot your way through to make sure you get a sense of what the visuals are going to look like.
Sure.
And one of my first jobs as an intern was to take a camera through actually the Ratatouille attraction and understand what this was going to look like so they had a video to look at and understand this process. But then what ended up happening is at R&D, our job is, it is often guided by a little bit of what's coming out in technology, what's emerging in robotics, what's emerging in AI. It comes out of a little bit of what do we think is just neat. And we ended up with this free-ranging vehicle platform that we just use for experimentation. Now, it's not uncommon for us to test a lot of these systems. In fact, I think we have a picture of what a normal sort of test vehicle looks like. You can see a team. You know, it's got all of the stuff on there. It's built out of plywood. It's very, you know, built. Yeah, thank you. It's built to get really close to what we think this specific ride is going to look like.
So this may be a ride-specific platform.
Yeah, and they start like this, and we do this all the time, right? Mock-ups are part of the fun of Imagineering.
Right.
So at R&D, we started taking one of these platforms and just adding things to it. So this one's got a motion base. We've got an Apple box holding up that computer monitor. We've got
no, it's an official Apple box,
this
official
is a,
Disney
yeah.
Apple box.
Okay. It's not sponsored.
Right.
But when we started playing with this, what we were looking at is what's interesting in the space of free-ranging vehicles. This is everything from the mechanical system to the onboard control system to the wayside control system to sensor systems to what does this even thing even do? How does it drive? And one thing we were just honestly just playing with, there's a person I work with every day named Michael Lardy who was playing with virtual reality. He had got it working on the vehicle. He had actually linked it up to a game engine. And this was, you know, 3 or 4 years ago. And there was this other team working on this Star Wars ride. Mm-hmm. And they're like, well, we have everything in a game engine already to pre-visualize it. We can ride through it because, like you said, we want to sit at our desk and understand the sight lines.
Right.
And he said, well, what if I just take your animation and I put the VR right on board and we'll just run it like that? We'll run both of these things concurrently and get the motion one-to-one. Because mm-hmm. I think there is sort of, you know, we use and love simulators, but there's just something about one-to-one exactly the motions, the human body is one of the greatest sensors ever
right.
created. And when you're talking about rides, you know, you can think about them as sort of just in it for the thrill. But as when Joe's saying you're kind of designing characters, you want this thing to feel good at just every moment, right? This has to feel not just like you're going forward and it can't just feel comfortable, it can't just feel safe, it also has to feel like that character is driving me forward.
Right.
And the only way to really confirm that is to put it all together. Mm-hmm. And so what we've ended up with now, this is a look at our current system. We have two vehicles. We have one 8-person vehicle, one 5-person vehicle, still has the motion base on board. And we use these things constantly to just experiment with the greatest metric, I think, on Earth, which is what's fun. Mm-hmm. Because there's no simulation that can tell you in a single plane, you know, from a bird's eye view, I can tell this is fun. Or from a concept painting, I can tell this is fun. You need those things
everybody
to get to
this point. Everybody knows isometric fun is the most.
it's my personal thing.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I do think that there's just, we do, you know, we have this thing of like, there's just people that just knows like that was it. That was the corner that felt right. Mm-hmm. And by putting it all on board where you have, you know, in that case, you can have 13 people at once experiencing, you know, sort of a moment from an attraction, you're closing the loop. And I think that, you know, it's not just for Imagineering, as I'm sure anyone here who has built anything ever, the time when you really understand it is when things start to come together. It's when that one system has to talk to that other system, has to talk to the person on board understanding the show or the story or the experience.
Mm-hmm.
And so for us, what this has allowed us to do is we have a custom vehicle system talking to VR, talking to a game engine that just lets us understand and come together really quickly.
Right. And, and I think we have a video of that the vehicle in action, so we can play that. And so how long did it take to develop this platform, roughly?
I think that's a tough question, because in truth, you know, this is us actually, this is literally footage, again, I don't know the year offhand, pre-motion base, actually doing Rise of the Resistance testing. This is, you can see me and Michael on board there playing with the motion base. This is it with our delightful show lighting, because we cannot be helped.
Well, of course,
in the entertainment industry. It'll make anything look, purple lighting, like thing looks really good.
Right, maybe add some orange and you get the Michael Bay,
But when it comes to length, I think really everything that we do at R&D is really more about iteration as opposed to length. Because what happened was, you know, we had this system that was, let's explore this aspect of a free-ranging vehicle. We have this system that was, well, I have this mechanical test I want to do. We have this one guy that's like, well, I kind of want to play with VR. And then suddenly we create something of value, and now, you know, I don't know how many, but tens of rides are using that system in order to understand exactly, you know, what their thing's going to feel like in the future. I mean, as far out as we've had rides that have come in 2 weeks into ideation, right? All they've got is the most basic 3D model someone put together on a laptop. In a matter of hours, you can be riding it. Mm-hmm. You can actually see what it feels like and looks like, and you get the wind in your face because it's just actual air moving around you.
Right.
We don't have to simulate that.
Yeah. okay, cool.